Hello guys, welcome back to a new episode of Urban Design on City Skylines with me, Priest. Now, what a beautiful view we have here from Oakwood. On the other side of the highway, we've got Chadstone, and we've got in the background the downtown area of Sant'Arcangelo. So, where we left off last episode was the area right in front of us, which was Chadstone. We were working on the first half of Chadstone, which shows or has more of the higher density residential people and citizens living in it. Now on this side of this main road avenue that we've got running across over here, we're going to start focusing on providing lower density residential areas into Chadstone. So we're pretty much just continuing off from where we left off last episode. So without further ado, let's get straight into it, eh? Alright, so now that we're back, first thing that I mentioned at the very end of last episode is I wanted to make sure that I can join this avenue up to Oakwood around over here. And that's exactly what we're going to do. Just first of all, I'm just going to pause the game for a quick second. I'm just going to make sure that we can just grab an avenue asset or building, and let's just see what we can do. If I just squeeze this out to here. Now we've got a few railway connections around over here which we have to consider as well, as they might get in our way. Now that I'm looking at it, they will most sure certainly definitely get in our way. So I want to see if we can just make something that goes straight in this direction. And we can't... Oh, yes, we can. Perfect. Just what I wanted to see. Now just push this across. It's just one railway track that's in our way, and that's this one. Let's remove these trees. They're in our way. This is also in our way, actually, now that I have a look at it. All right, so I'm just going to push this out to here and then out to, say, around over here. And now let's just see. We can just join this up. Yes, we can. Don't really like that connection though, now do I? No. So push this out to somewhere around there. This out to here. And let's see, can we make a nice smooth transition somewhere around here? Yes, we can. Like that. That's a lot better. Okay, much smoother. So this pretty much ends up right here, right on the bounds and right inside, deep inside this neighborhood. Now perhaps we should get rid of these housing, this a few of these houses from within here, I reckon. Let's just remove them, and what I'll do is just replace them with some trees. There we go, that's fine. And now, we have a couple of dead areas around over here, so, actually no, that was actually working well, because we've got that mod which we can use, so actually I'm just going to push this out forward, out to here, and then from here we can just do the usual curve like that, jump into our roads, create a pedestrian path like that, and there we go. I really do think that will work now. Let's just jump back into our tree assets, place a few more trees in and around. Okay, done, and there we go. I think that's good. Continue the simulation now. All is well. We can also add perhaps a nice tall building around over here as well. Yeah, that's what's going to happen right there. So, we've got a bit of a nice quick exit point out of Oakwood that goes towards Chadstone. Okay, so now we're going to start working on these little quiet, slightly quieter neighborhoods that revolve in and around of Chadstone. So first things first, what I was thinking is perhaps we can make a one-directional road which goes in this direction. But this is going to affect the bus stop right over here, which is not entirely what I want. So right over here, that's what I want. Push this across in this direction. That bus stop is fine. It's relatively untouched. I'm just going to push this out a little bit further. Make this head in this direction. Push this out further. Make this come across over here. Remove that and that. Okay. So we've got lights over here. They're always going to be lights over here. Yeah. So right now over here, I'm thinking perhaps what we can do is add a bit of a cul-de-sac. So if I just add something like that, make this go out by two and around and in this direction, I can make a little bit of a cul-de-sac like that. I think that's fine. But this is four and four. That's not entirely what I was hoping for around over here exactly. I think I need to push this slightly further out actually. So just before we do start filling in this area with a few more residential buildings, what I want to do is make sure that I can zone a nice area like this. Okay, so now remove that and join up a little segment like that. This can go out by two, out by two. There we go. Remove that, build this out to here. There we go. And so this will give me a bit of space in between for soundproofing. Because we have also a lot of demand right now, at this very moment, I'm just going to zone a bit of this, a bit of commercial on either side. There we go. And on either side over here, we've got our beautiful little plazas. Where do we have them? Where do we have our little plazas? Yeah, this is what I wanted to place on either side. There we go. Perfect. Actually, no, that's not it. That's not what I wanted to place. Large, small playground. Or is it? Yeah, that's what I wanted to place. I think. I'm not entirely sure anymore. Dog park? No. Let's see. All our assets. So many assets now. No, 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 no. Yeah, that was it. That's what I wanted to place down. Okay. Thought it looked different. Anyway, it's all good. Next, we are actually now going to start placing and zoning some of our low-density residential zones. So I'm not going to join this road up straight away immediately around over here. What I'm going to do is make this road jump across out in this general direction and make this jump up to around here and just join up like that. There we go. And there you go, this road is already being utilized. This is very good to see. Very happy with this result. And let's see what we can do over here now. If I push this road out to here, let's just remove that for a second. If I push this out to here, yeah, that's actually going to work if we do a 4x4. There we go. And what we can do now is place a little bit of a cul-de-sac over here as well. Zone some more residential buildings. Let's just zone all of this up. Why not? Get rid of these few trees which are in this area because they'll add to our count and we don't want that adding to our source, to our total count. There we go. Now the question is, I removed these train lines. That's a big bad mistake. Need to push this through to here and now just rejoin that like that. And now this needs to be pushed through a little bit further up and now out and across like that. All right. So we have a look at our train lines now, please be fixed. Yeah, all our train lines will be fixed now. Well, I hope that will be fixed anyway. They should be because it's all connected now. This metro line is not turned on. We need to turn that on. Why wasn't that turned on? Yeah. We're not getting any usage out of this. Oh well. Now we will get usage out of that. So, yes, look at this. Look at the amount of people we have now swarming into this metro line. Wow, look at that. All waiting for the yellow. The yellow comes and picks everyone up. There we go. And where are you going? You're going off to Vela's. So, everything is good and functioning here now. Well, hopefully a lot better. Wow, there's a lot of people waiting here. Yellow will come, drop people off. Yeah, look at that. I think this area is just going to get really busy right now. Look at all these people. That's fantastic to see. This light green line needs to be a little bit quicker and more efficient, I think. Where are all the trains? All the metro trains on this line. I'm afraid that this line might be just a little bit too long. Where are the trains? Let's just jump on here. Why do we have only one vehicle? That's not what I want to see. Add vehicle. I want like five at least. Come on. What is this? Metro line, add vehicle. Five. The first two can only have like three. Three is enough because they're small lines. Why does every single metro line have only one? Alright, so I've got to get rid of this mod because this mod is absolutely ridiculous. So bear with me, guys. Yeah, I'm going to turn this mod off and come back and see how we go. So we'll be right back, I guess. Although this recording is for YouTube, so just with this transition, we'll be back, eh? Alright guys, so now that we're back, as you can see straight away, after the mod has been disabled, you can have a look, quick look at our metro lines, and straight away what you can see is we've got all our lines now operating properly with the correct amount of train lines or metro actual services on each line, depending on the length. So this is very good to see all the way throughout. Previously we saw only like one vehicle per line, and now we're actually seeing the right amount showing up, and I think it wasn't only our metro but buses as well that were getting affected. So now that mod's turned off, I don't like to have control over that. I like the game to know what it should do based on the budget, and hopefully this will help us financially as well. Let's just have a quick look. Everything seems to be working a little bit better. There's less people waiting here because I think we're starting to see that we're getting a lot more services now operating. So this is exactly what I wanted to see. Let's see this stop. Yeah, this is much better, much better. And hopefully our buses have will get onto the job quickly as well themselves. So I'm not seeing many buses around at the moment. Ah, here you go. You see? They're all piling out of the bus depots at the moment. So all our areas, now that the mod's been turned off, the correct amount of buses are now slowly making their way out for each line. So the public transport service will have to take some time to fully initialize and kick in. The metro and trains will already be operating perfectly, but the buses will need some time to catch up because the bus stops are just going to get completely overcrowded very quickly. Just look at this, all these buses just trying to jump out. So we weren't even functioning properly with our after installation of that mod. So now that it's gone, we'll just give it time for that to all calm down and get back into working order. Now, while we wait for that, what I'm thinking is we can continue expanding our city, hey? So out by 4 over here, we'll do another little segment out by here. This can go out to here. This can jump out to there. I can push this out to, say, somewhere around over here. No. If we push this out to, say, there, then I could potentially push something out to here. And let's see what we can do here. That's 4. And if this is 4, let's go jump another 4, another 4. No, that's too much for this side. So this side only 4. This I can jump up another 4. This another 2 perhaps. 3. That's fine. And no, that's not fine. That's not fine. But yeah. Yeah, that's actually not bad. Okay, so we'll leave that like that. This can now jump out to there. And actually, no, what we might do is make this. Actually, this can jump out to here like that. Now what I'll do is make a little short segment which goes out like this. Make this go straight out by 4. This can be pushed out to here. And then out to 4. There we go. And now just join that up like that. Okay, and I'll make another cul-de-sac right over here. There we go. And perhaps we can squeeze in another cul-de-sac cell around over here. Perfectly, like that. Okay. Awesome. Absolutely awesome. Now, the next thing that we can do is potentially... What's this? Oh, this road was only a guide. Okay. So what I'm thinking is we can push this out even further, out to say around over here. Now let's just go out by 5, go up by 5, push up by 4, this can push out by 5, maybe even, yep. And just join that up, there we go. And even over here, why not? Just do that, that actually has to be removed, out to here. 5x5, perfect. So this area will really start to develop and flourish very quickly. There we go, expand on all of this, this area as well. Now I'm assuming everything is still under the influence. Yes, pretty much everything is still under the influence of being connected with pipes. Just in case, what I'll do is extend the connections through an extra click. There we go. Okay. Look at the development straight away. We're seeing a lot of development happen. And you know what? While we're seeing this, I'm just going to zone all of this up. Let's not just wait and slowly develop, because we do have the demand. So as this starts to build up, we can potentially even add some commercial shopping around over here. Like so. Now these few houses might be a little bit close to commercial buildings, but such only there'll be only a few, so I'm sure it'll be fine. And later on we can perhaps add another street or something around over here to make this all join up a little bit more naturally, I reckon. Everything is connected here. Yes, it is. How are the buses? I'm sure that these buses are, yeah, they're still trying to pile out and make their way around, and we've got ourselves a bit of a standstill. How about that? There you go. This bus is not full. This bus is emptying people to go to the metro, I assume. Alright, anyway, so buses are starting to circulate in a few of these areas, and especially around in this downtown area. I think, where is our main depot around here? Yeah, now we're starting to see a lot more buses show up and services. So this is good. Perhaps now while we're over here, I'm thinking let's just add another service. Let's add a cemetery. We don't have one on the far end over here. So let's just add one. Like so. That still gives us the space. Yes, it does, to make a few more homes. Now, there we go. All this can be zoned up. All of this. There we go. Remove these two. Let's just get the paint bucket. There we go. This might be a little bit quicker. Alright, so let's just have a quick look at our education. So education will definitely be struggling. So what I'm going to do is straight away add an education into this area right here in the middle. That way it can affect all of this area of Chadstone. And I think that's as far as we're going to go with Chadstone. We'll make it, maybe make one exit point and that's about it. So we'll have to somehow find a way to tie in these avenues all up together. So I'll find a way to do that off camera though, because I'm not entirely sure how that's going. We're going to proceed with that. High school education is not necessarily the best around here, but what I'm going to do is I'll persist in actually making one. So I'll place one right there. Okay. Make sure that we've got power connected straight away so that people will be happy. And this area around over here, we could do with a bit of residential, I think. Or should we add a few offices around here? No, not offices. What I'm going to do is add some... This can be shopping. There we go. And I'll add a park. That sounds like a good idea. What I'll do is... What about this? That will be fine. We can add some housing around over here. There we go. And perhaps even a dog park can fit around over here. Perfect. Alright. Because we do need to keep our citizens entertained. And perhaps another dog park on this corner right over here. Like so. Alright. Our commercial area has pretty much boomed, so this is good. We'll add some more high density residential, commercial right over here on this edge. And I think we can place some more over here, why not? Like so, and some lower right over here. There we go. Now let's see how we're doing with our education around over here. Wow, universities are really struggling. We really need to start maybe thinking about adding some more universities. Even though our capacities are well and truly over, I think a couple of universities will definitely really help. The question is where to place one. I think right over here would be quite well suited. Or even maybe around over here. Somewhere. No, I think this was the top spot. It affects quite a lot of areas. This area, that's too big. Too big of an area to cover. Yeah, I don't see anywhere that's going to affect... Oh, here we go, right here. But that's too close from over here to the Caulfield campus, I reckon. And the Velas. It's right in between both, actually. Now, I think this would be a slightly better location. Are we able to place it or not? Yes, we are. There we go. But I want it to be placed up against the avenue, though, please. And we'll add some nice trees. There we go. That's all nice and done. Just add a few of these trees as well. Let's see if we can find the bushes. So just like we did in Tottenham, we'll just add a few of these bushes in as well, just to make it not look so plain on the actual ground itself around over here. There we go. And hopefully this will help a lot of these areas with all the education needs, and we might start seeing some taller buildings start popping up. Well, I can hear a lot of buildings upgrading. You can hear that. I'm sure you can in the ding, 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 ding. Everyone's happy and upgrading. So this is very good to hear. And now this whole area is now starting to just join up. This little big gap that we had around over here is now just making all this just seem like all as one big connection. And the buses are still trying to pour out. So how many buses have we had? 174 from here and 216 from here, but they're still pouring out. I'm trying to get out. Come on, hurry up. Move, 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 move. Go, 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 go. Alright, so... wow, this is starting to really pile up, but this will eventually clear itself up, that's for sure. It just shows how much this area has now developed since we've introduced Chadstone, and our population has gone up to 170, just under 170 now. So this is good. Our demand for commercial has gone down a little bit. Our demand for residential has gone down to very low. But we have many areas available to expand into, so this is good as well. I'm going to add a few trees in and around over here, just so that a few of these areas around in Chester can actually start looking like they belong and just look completed. Over here, we can add a footpath so that we can kind of work our magic. There we go. Add the trees. There we go. And a few ferns. There we go. I'm liking that a lot. And now it's just, I'm wondering whether or not we should start thinking about perhaps even adding a few housing around over here on this beach. Or this little cove area. Actually, you know what? No. I'm going to leave this because just like I said a couple of episodes ago, where I left areas of Long Beach, and that's exactly one of the comments that I received actually an episode or two ago by someone asking what are my plans for the expansion pack of After Dark. And so definitely one of my plans, because supposedly there's a lot of new assets for night commercial districts, and even like more additions to like beach decorations, I believe, or just general usage for beaches, and even perhaps cargo harbors or just harbors for private yachts. I don't know, but apparently there's some more availability to stuff that joins up more with the water. So that's why I've left this area clear for the time being around Long Beach, and all of this is now empty. And I still haven't filled up this area because depending on what happens with After Dark, I want to make sure that I still have a little bit of an area available for that expansion pack so that later on I can know definitely for sure what I want it is that I want to do. And that's what I'm thinking about over here. We've got this little cove area, and yeah, I'm going to leave this vacant for the time being and just wait for the expansion pack to come out, which is in, what's today, probably about 2.5 to 3 weeks away right now. So yeah, I'm just going to leave that for now. So that's the plans for After Dark. And depending on what we can do in terms of like night districts with nighttime businesses, we might start looking into the possibility of adding some extra businesses into the downtown area that highly or larger or have better usage during the night, because that what seems to be happen in real life. Also, while we were away off camera, I think it was the last episode, as promised 2 episodes ago, I was going to get rid of all the residential buildings within this block, with this triangular block, and that's what I've done. And I've added some more businesses, and that's exactly what we've got. We've got a lot more skyscrapers in just this little small vicinity, and so it just makes this area just join up a little bit smoother towards all these tall buildings around over here. So yeah, I like that. I'm not too fond of these though, residential buildings in Central Park, so I will eventually probably get rid of them and replace them with commercial buildings. I think it will just make a little bit more sense, but we'll leave them for now. And yeah, that is that. Let's see what else. Okay, so we've just had a spike for demand in commercial, and our buses area over here has cleared out. How's our traffic? Our traffic is clearing out slowly. It was out to the ramp, so now it's just gone back a bit. So this is good. This ramp is now clearing out as well, so everything's starting to function a little bit better now. And I assume that our public transport as well is... Where's our public transport? Yeah, we don't have too many people waiting at bus stops now, and the metro lines are now also covering the system fairly well. The blue line goes away, and the yellow comes in. This is exactly what I wanted to see. Perfect. So, 450 passengers on a metro train? Really? That's really, really good. That's a really large hauling capacity. Blue comes in. Yeah, we're seeing much better usage now of our public transport system now that the game itself controls how many trains are used per line. There we go. Yeah, this is very good. And these bus stops are also... look at this. People are getting off this bus stop and just jumping across the street to get to this metro station. So everything is working out just beautifully. So we do have more demand for shopping, for commercial. So I've got an idea. Perhaps we can even clear out a little bit more space around this area. So what I have in mind is these areas around over here. So what I'm going to do is we're going to clear out all of this, all of these residential blocks from here. There we go. There we go. Let's just remove you. And so these residential areas will slowly just start to build elsewhere within our map region. And I'm hoping that it all relocates to Chadstone while we have many areas available over there. And in the meantime, over here, this is all going to be high density commercial. So perhaps we can get a few more skyscrapers to just join in to the fun. Are we seeing any other progress around over here? No. All the buildings are still relatively the same. Elementary, high schools are all the issue around over here. Elementary and high schools. I think this is the biggest problem. Elementary and high schools. So let's see. High schools. Alright, so let's just place another high school around over here. Hopefully this will get people to be a little bit more happier in this area. And we've got one elementary school already over here, so let's just add another one. Hopefully this will add a bit more happiness to people and just help make these areas upgrade, because I'm hoping that these schooling things will help. And this ramp is not clearing out yet. Need to hurry up. This intersection is completely full, as it usually always is. because it's the only and pretty much main exit to get to the highway. It's got me thinking if I should make another connection somewhere around over here, which leapfrogs or goes underneath these rail lines. But I think we should be fine. This ramp is being used, I think. I just saw it, yeah. One person used this ramp, so this is a good sign to see. Alright, so we have now added all those commercial buildings in here. We're slowly seeing them. Yeah. Please don't tell me I put... No, I didn't put low density. I put high density. Okay, so that's all good. So hopefully the influx of commercial will lessen at least a little bit over here in Carnegie. And we might start seeing some more progress happening around over here in Chadston. Now that we are actually here, let's just quickly place a few extra trees. Since this little cul-de-sac is now pretty much all done and finished. Add a few more of these trees surrounding this. Maybe a few more around over here somewhere, like this. There we go. A few more areas around like here. Need to be filled out. And this whole Central Park area. There we go. Perhaps I can add something like a playground around here as well. Let's see quickly what can we do. I wouldn't mind a dog park, actually. Dog parks are always a winner, I reckon. So we'll just add a dog park here. That should help increase the want for people to live around this area. Now let's see if we can just push this road through over here. No, we can't. Well, that sucks. Way, come on. How hard of a connection can this be to make? All right, so we'll make it with a curve then. Like that. Hey, too easy. And it looks good because it's not straight. All right. And because we still have... Wow, look at the demand for commercial. The commercial demand is just something ridiculous. So just keep zoning in more commercial now. Near the beach side over here. Since this is what is requested and required. And then the continuation will have some more residential. It's just a little strip of commercial buildings around over here. Around over here, I think, I know it would definitely be beneficial for us to upgrade this road. And all of this as well. There we go. So all these roads are now nice and fancy. Now, before we continue any further, what I want to do is add another couple of bus lines. Now that this area of Chadston is now pretty much completed, I'm thinking that we can pretty much be safe with knowing that we can expand a little bit further and connect Chadston to this metro line. And so the way I'm going to do that is we're going to have to make quick and short little routes. So I can't start it from there. So essentially what I want to do is make a stop which stops somewhere around over here. No. Where do I want this to go? Through the neighborhood, of course, but so through on this side it's gonna go up through, can't get through there, so that's a bit of a problem. So get rid of that stop. Push you through to here. And then essentially I'm going to make you come around to here. And then make you stop around over here. Stop at the metro station. Then make you turn this way. Stop there. Stop here. And then jump around and take these outer routes. Take the outer route. There we go. So I think that will work. Let's just jump onto this bus lane. And just change the color to something that will stand out from the rest a little bit. Yellow. Yes, that will do. Gold and yellow. So next, we need another bus lane which goes slightly further inside of this neighborhood. So we'll go through here. Out to here. No, stop. Go closer to here. Stop there. You can stop with this stop. Come over here. Push through to here. Out over here. And push through here. Stop with this stop. Stop at the metro station. Then make your way around over. You can't go this way. That's all one way, is it? Yes. Okay, so you're going to have to keep going straight. Stop over here. And make your way around over here. And then stop there. Okay. Alright, so that's this line done. I'll just quickly change the color of it. To something dark blue. There we go. Real intense blue. And we should start seeing some, yes, a lot of new buses start showing up. And this area will start filling in with even more buses because it is like a main central hub area. And hopefully with this addition, we'll have a bit of an increase in popularity in this area of Chadston. So yeah, let's see, what else can we do? Let's try and fill out this little area around over here. I'm really not enjoying having such a large vacant area here. So I'm thinking perhaps we have to use the straight tool. I think the straight tool is the way to go. And somewhere from over here, if we can just join this up out to here, this can come out to here. And now let's just jump across, join up like that. Yeah, that's not too bad. Can remove this. What we can do now is change the direction of this road going that way. Next thing that I'm going to do is this needs to be now upgraded to high density. This is going to be high density. So is this. The rest of these are low density. This can be high density, high density. All this high density. There we go. These couple in here in the middle, low density, low density. And the rest can be just low density. And hopefully this will increase or reduce our demand for commercial. And as you can see, our population is still rising. We're up to 171,000. So we're definitely on our way to reaching 200k, which would be quite an achievement on hard mode. Right now, just to make this area look also pretty, and our demand for, just as soon as we finish this, look at our demand, is just plummeted. We do not need any more. demand for, yeah, any more demand for, commercial. So, we've done a good job. I think the commercial area inside the downtown area of Santa Arcangelo has really boomed. So, push this out over here and just join that up like that. And over here, just zone up a couple more quick areas. Yep, and this as well over here. Beautiful. And now, just to make this area start looking a little bit cleaner, all it is a bit of repetition now of what we're doing. Just soundproofing a little bit now. But it's all part of the progress to complete our city. And to make it look beautiful. Alright. Now let's see, a few of these nice trees in as well. There we go. Just fill this area in randomly, as most randomly as I can, with these trees. There we go. And as soon as I'm done with these trees, I'll zoom out and we'll just have a quick glance at what all of this tree placing is essentially does. There we go. Let's put a few more of these trees for the soundproofing for Chadston area. This area is still developing, so we'll just let that develop. We can just keep placing a few more of these trees in and amongst all these buildings. There we go. Let's get our ferns or pines or whatever they are. There we go. Just a couple of these in and between, just to break up the height levels a little bit. There we go. Okay, so that's looking good. Can put a couple of these pines around over here as well. And a few over here that we forgot to place around as well. See, there's always a little bit of work here when you're doing a bit of a city beautification. And this whole area as well. There we go. Let's return to our pines. Oh, what are they? Pines. They are pines, not ferns. Okay, good. Alright, so more of these trees in over here as well. Actually, yeah, that's it. We're not going to add any walkways or pathways in and around over here. So this is all nice and good. There we go. What I do want to do though quickly is jump into our road tool, create a pedestrian crossing right over here and another one right over here. Perhaps one over here as well. We can definitely do with a few pedestrian crossings in and amongst these longer sized or lengthened streets. So there we go. That's all fine. This area is fine. What's that? That's just a normal business. We don't need a footpath around over there to a crossing, I mean. One over here. Don't need one there. That's all good and fine. Now let's go quickly back to our pine trees. Place a few in around over here. And I think this is all going to be now pretty much done and complete. Look how much the city over here is just completely filled out with trees, and it doesn't look so empty anymore. It just looks like it's always been here with all of this. So this has actually worked out really well, and our population is still increasing. So just before we finish this episode, I'm just gonna quickly have a look at Just give me a second. I'm just looking at my cat. It's trying to eat my lasagna, which I left on my desk. So I need to push this away. All right. No, no coming here. Okay. No Supre. No. Yes, you can smell my finger. You want to pull my finger? No. All right. Anyway, I'm back. Let's see what we can do. What were we going through? Okay, so we got our public transport system up and running. That pretty much covers most areas, and most areas over here are pretty much very happy with the service that they are getting. Education-wise, primary school, one may not be enough over here. We've got two... Yeah, you know what? Let's just add one more. Why not? I'll add one more here. Okay, education pays for itself, I reckon. Now, I've learned that the hard way. High school, these areas still need to educate themselves through primary schools before this high school starts taking effect. And university, of course, as well. Actually, speaking of university, I think we could do with another one. We've got one over here. We've got one, yeah, I reckon we could do with another university somewhere in perhaps even Long Beach. But that I'm going to have to do some considerations off camera to see where. Even Levante could do with university. I'm not too sure. So, but that's something we'll consider in the near future. And I will discuss that off camera as well. Now look at that. That's the low end. I mean the low density zone of Chadston, all done and completed, all nice and happy, and that's it. So guys, hope you enjoyed this quick little episode, slightly shorter I think, and I guess what we can say is Chadston is completed. We still have demand for medium, demand for commercial and for residential. I'm going to have to try and figure out how to do the other end side of this area, of this end of Chadston. So, I mean, I'm going to put some sort of avenue or main road, which will split these this area up a little bit so that we can potentially start working on another true. I think we can fit another true suburbs around over here. So this avenue might actually join up with this avenue and, yeah, we'll split it up in half or something like that. I'm not sure. But we'll figure it out as we go. We might even be able to join up two of these suburbs. Or you know what? I might not even put an avenue in between over here. I'll just put another road on the other side, which will be a completely separate neighborhood. But we'll have some sort of connection, yeah, to maybe Oakwood or even to this main avenue around over here. So, yeah, guys, hope you enjoyed this episode, and especially the last one as well. I know it was a little bit long. It's perhaps like both episodes have been focusing on our Chadston neighborhood, but as you can see, it's slow progress, but we're pretty much looking after everything incrementally, taking care of all the education needs, public transportation needs, making sure that all our electricity and water demands are met, just so that we don't have any surprises later on while we're developing our city and we don't have any major issues. And as you can see over here with this roundabout over here, well, as you can see, it is working very well because it's still... Well, it's eventually going to clear out all this traffic around over here. It's just going to take a bit of time, but it will clear out. That's the main thing, that when you're building your city and you're dealing with large populations, the best advice I can give you is just to persist with waiting for traffic to clear, because it will eventually clear at some stage, and eventually it will also probably build up again and clear up again. It's just a funny process of the way traffic works. It's like pretty much a rush hour in the morning and in the evening. So yeah, that is that, guys. Hope you enjoyed this episode. Coming up very soon also is that tutorial, as I've been promising, on the highways. It'll be a multi-episode, a few staged episodes on the basic layouts of how I make my highways realistic and function well, because I know you guys have been asking for it. So yeah, Thank you guys for watching. If you're a new person, please subscribe. I'll have plenty more episodes coming up very, very soon, and lots of tutorials as well on guides for City Skylines. And yeah, definitely a lot more episodes on future development of the neighborhoods surrounding our main city. So eventually we're going to start building all this up and joining up to Richland and Stroud and all that. So yeah, remember guys, also to hit that like and comment button. Let me know how you like Chadston, if you really think I should add something else, or if you don't like it, please just let me know. If there's even something that you don't like, just let me know. I'll look into it, and maybe I can maybe find a solution that will suit make everybody happy, even though it's going to be very difficult. But yeah, I'd like to hear from everyone, and I'll try and get back to everyone's comments as well. So for now guys, take care. I'll see you all very soon. Bye bye.